Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, this is Mike B along with
Dakpo. We're going to be watching winner semis, Infinity versus McBad, Meta Knight versus Ness. And they've got the okay to start. And here they go.
3, 2, 1, go! And here we go, folks.
Wow. It's interesting watching this neutral position. Awestin started on the bottom, and I guess when I would feel the pressure to like go back, Awestin, when the game started, he didn't move back at all. He stood there. Such an aggressive player. I love it. Is that the jump? No, he saw the jump. Great air dodge. I'll try my best Lunchables.
And to answer your question, Nai Ali, there is a girl that does play Smash here, and her name is Beck. So if you ever see Beck, she is the only female player here so far.
Commanding lead so far. But that could change one swift movement. Both these characters, if they just get a hand on each other, then they're gonna tear each other apart. Misread the tech. And did the same roll, and Awestin hadn't adapted yet. We probably won't see that same roll option a third time. Infinity is smarter than that. A B is great against Meta Knight, simply because when Meta Knight or any character is recovering, the best way to deal with Ness or Lucas throwing an up B at you is just to hit it. But all of Meta Knight's moves are transcendent and don't really clank with it, so it's really hard for Meta Knight to get around it. Oddly enough.
Pretty even so far.
Yep. Got his hands. Good punish. Not letting Awestin just take advantage on shield. A little advice to some of the new players to Smash. Your punish game is probably, in my opinion, one of the defining characteristics of how good you are and mature as a player. Because if you let people get away with stuff, they're just gonna keep on trying and you're gonna get yourself in bad positions, but you have to make them respect you. And that's what a lot of the game is.
That's good advice right there, because I'm a new player myself, so.
Yeah, definitely.
That's good advice right there.
Just about everything is punishable. There are a few things that are frame safe, but there are very, very few things that are. And usually every character has an option.
Here we are, 2-2, even Steven, 0-0.
Yeah, Meta Knight missing his normal down air right about now. He could go out there and just down air Ness when he's trying to recover. We're all anyways. Wow, I don't think Infinity's gotten hit with Saibi yet. This is pretty incredible.
Yeah, so far, a good matchup. I mean, he's been on his game tonight, I will say. I've been watching Infinity for a while. He's definitely on his game, especially that last showing he had.
Oh yeah, versus Luck. Dang. Avoids that PK fire once again. Still... Oh, what's going on here? Oh. Little platform confusion throwing off both players. But... Oh! That is just really harsh combo. He's gotta stay cool. If he gets angry right now, he's gonna lose it.
Yeah. You gotta keep your cool, keep your composure.
That's the one thing I worry about when Infinity plays. If he gets angry, it's gonna be really tough.
Yeah. Oh wow. Infinity felt that one close.
So yeah, Ness is low tier. Definitely low tier city. So is Game & Watch. All these characters are pretty terrible. Come to low tier city, guys.
Infinity's shaking off that last one. He's staying focused. interesting to see where what stage they pick next. Meanwhile, Oracle's checking his phone. To see how this one turns out.
I'm kind of curious to why he picked this stage versus Ness. I'm guessing he's just not wanting Ness to get away, but I mean, it goes both ways.
Yeah, he's getting frustrated early.
Yeah, stay cool, Infinity.
Yeah,
you got
stay
this.
Cool, buddy. Hang in there.
Good down smash.
Edge guard coming, maybe? No.
So, like, a little terminology refreshment. Edge guarding is like hitting people away from the ledge, and when you're gonna grab the ledge so that they can't grab it, it's called edge hogging.
Edge hogging, there we go. That's
yeah.
The word. Okay.
Okay, oh, that could have been a great opportunity to punish. I missed out a little bit. There we go. Awestin just doing a fantastic job comboing Meta Knight, using his weight to his advantage. It's just so awesome to see how Awestin has control over this really odd character. Like, the main form is weird. It's a really goofy person, really goofy character.
Oh no,
that's it.
No.
Infinity's in.
He's in trouble here.
He's using Rage.
Cool. Yeah.
Rage.
Stay cool.
Only has 20 power on the first turn.
Oh.
It's not good.
Yeah, stays. Recovery.
Oh, that was beautiful. And Sean is right back in the game.
He's right back in it. There's a question for you. Since you're watching this, are you getting a good scouting report in? Assuming you're winning.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Awestin doesn't change his playstyle very much. His playstyle is hard to fight against in the first place. There's usually not much he needs to change. Sean is super, super, super adaptive and super player versus player oriented. Not very much, match character matchup, just player matchup. And that's the thing. Awestin is such a unique playstyle. He can't just like, oh, I'm playing Awestin. I'm playing against this thing. I'm not sure. No one really knows why Awestin is so good. But that just makes Awestin really hard to read. Spoilers.
There it is.
That's that.
There it is. There's that. Infinity. A disappointing look. Well, that was still interesting. That was still an interesting matchup right there. I mean, those two definitely go at it when I see them play.
It looks like it's going to be me and Awestin in Winners Finals.
Is that up next?
It might be. It depends on what they want to call. Oh, hey, good.
And here is Infinity.